Before starting this video, my tribute to my mother who died on 13 October 2020 and was an always helped me for all the way. Hand tools for bench work. This is the topic of works of technology and it's a volume 2. So there are numerous tools used in workshop, but before that it is necessary to use proper tool in proper place for a particular job as its storage after use by an aviation mechanics. Here I am going to describe hammer, punches, screwdriver, pliers, clamping and holding devices, wrenches, hacksaw and sawing, files and filing, chisels and chipping, soldering and other small tools. Their uses, precautions while its use or safety measures. Now how we'll describe it and make it type of hand tools. See, the type of tools are such. First of all is pounding tools, in which hammers and punches comes. Holding tools, which comes pliers and cutter. Third is cutting tools, A, chisels. Number two is files, C is shears, and then D will go for saws, E for drills, F for hole cutters, G for rimmers, H for taps and dies, and I as turning tools. When using a hammer or mallet, choose the one best suited for the job and ensure that the handle is tight. When striking a blow with the hammer, use the forearm as an extension of the handle. Swing the hammer by bending the elbow, not the wrist. Always strike the work squarely with the full face of the hammer. Always keep the faces of hammers and mallets smooth and free from dents to prevent marring the work. Technicians are often judged by their knowledge of tools and by the condition in which they keep their tools, in the maintenance or overall of aircraft, or in fact any piece of machinery. It is often necessary to use a variety of hand and power tools. For this reason, it is essential that technician be well informed and skilled in the use of activities. Mechanically minded people who have had experience with the tools over a period of a few years may feel that their knowledge is adequate and that their skill in the use of tools is satisfactory for the performance of maintenance tasks. They may be surprised, however, when they learn many of the details concerning common hand tools. They will probably find that there are many uses for tools with which they were not familiar, and that there are proper and improper methods for using tools that they had not previously understood. Tools are designed for many purposes and for working with a variety of different materials. For example, in metal work, we use hammer, hacksaws, shears, drills, chisels, and various other tools particularly adapted to metal working. For woodwork, we require wood saws, wood chisels, hammers, mallets, planes, auger, beads, sanding machines, and other special woodworking tools. For measuring either metals or wood, we require various measuring tools. Among these are carpenter squares, small tri squares, steel measuring tapes, steel rules, wooden rules, micrometer calipers, and various other measuring tools or gauges. We have to mention also, while using these tools, we have to mention the precautions while using the various types of tools in aviation. Occasionally, it is necessary to use a soft-faced hammer which has a striking surface made up of wood, brass, lead, rawhide, and rubber or plastic. These hammers are intended for use in forming soft metals and striking surfaces that are easily damaged. Soft faced hammers should not be used for rough work. Striking punch heads, bolts or nails will quickly ruin this type of hammer. A mallet is a hammer like tool which is a head made of hickory, rawhide or rubber. It is handy for shaping thin metal parts without denting them. Always use a wooden mallet when pounding a wood chisel or a gouge. When using a hammer or mallet, choose the one bit suited for the job. Ensure that the handle is tight. When striking a blow with the hammer, use this forearm as an extension of the handle. As we have discussed earlier, swing the hammer by bending the elbow, not the wrist. This we have also discussed. Always strike the work squarely with the full face of this hammer. These are all the precautions. And now the last one we also discussed, that is always keep the faces of hammers and mallets smooth and free from the dents to prevent marring the work. Now first question related to hammer is, what are hard and soft hammers? A hard hammer is one that is made of carbon steel and forged to shape and size. It is heat treated to make the striking face hard. A soft hammer may have the entire head made of soft metals such as lead, babbitt, copper or brass. Soft faced hammers have only their striking surface made up of plastic, rubber or rawhide. The faces are either clamped or press fitted on the metal hammer head. Now the question number 2, what are the some uses of hard hammer? A hard hammer is used for striking punches, cold chisels, steel letters and figures. It is also used for forging hot metals. Now riveting hot metals are riveting, bending, straightening, pinning, stretching and swaging. What are the some uses of soft hammers? Soft hammers are used when striking finished or semi-finished work pieces to prevent marring the finished surfaces. For example, soft hammers are commonly used for sitting a workpiece in a machine vise or tapping finished work being set up for a machining or layout operation. Now, question number 4. Describe the hard hammers most commonly used by machinists and identify their parts, indicate an important use of each hammer. The hammers most commonly used by machinists are the ball pin, the straight pin, and the cross pin. The flat face of the ball pin is used for general work such as striking punches. The rounded ball end is used for riveting and pinning. The straight pin, which has a pin and parallel to the axis of the handle, is used for stretching and drawing out metal when forging. The cross pin, which has a pin end and at right angles to the hammer handle, is used for riveting, stretching and drawing metal. What is meant by pinning or swaging? Pinning or swaging is the stretching or spreading of metal by hammering. Examples of pinning include flattening the end of a rivet, spreading a babbitt metal to it fit tightly in a bearing, and straightening a bar by stretching it short side. Why should a hammer handle be gripped near the end? A hammer handle should be gripped near the end so that full leverage may be obtained when swinging the hammer. A solid blow is difficult to deliver when the handle is gripped too close to the head of the hammer. The amount of force with which the hammer strike depends in part of the length of the handle and the weight of the head. To get the most advantage of the handle length, it should be held as it far from the head as possible. How is the size of hammers specified? Which we have discussed earlier, the size of a hard hammer is specified by the weight of a head without the handle. Ball pin hammer size ranges from 2 oz, that is 2 to 3 pounds. Sizes of soft faced hammers are specified by the diameter of the face and the length of the head and range from 5 by 8 inches diameter to 3 inches diameter. Faces are specified in the degrees of hardness from super soft to extra hard.